The wait is over. Fight week is over. Weigh-ins are over. The press conference is over. It is fight night. Clarissa Shields, Savannah Marshall to crown an undisputed champion. We're on Sky Sports. We're on ESPN Plus. It's Boxer, and this is our venue tonight, the O2 in London.
Right. Well,
this is a proper building here.
Are you going to do that right here?
The main event. Who knows? 10 years in the making. Clarissa Shields, a phenomenon. She's done everything in the sport, but the one problem, the one person she hasn't got past is Savannah Marshall. And everybody tells me Savannah Marshall is punching harder than ever. She's knocking out guys in the gym. She's got every chance of becoming the undisputed champion, but she's got to stop Clarissa Shields getting into a rhythm. Shields gets into a rhythm and gets inside. It's her fight.
And then left.
Don't you fucking know. I knew you'd say that.
I'm just looking at her.
What are you talking about? Is she nervous to fight? No, she's not. She's ready just to kick ass. That's what I've worked for.
Ben, how good is it to have a sold-out arena tonight?
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen an arena this full at this time. Everyone knows something special's in store. You can feel it. Everyone knows they're here for something historic, and they're going to remember it, hopefully, for the rest of their lives. So it's incredible to be here, yeah.
How much are you looking forward to the main event?
Main event is everything. The winner of this becomes the best female boxer on the planet, the biggest female boxer on the planet, and that's what's on the line. All the belts, Ring Magazine, everything. And it can go either way.
Listen, this is a massive moment for women's boxing and women's sport, filling the O2, 20,000 people. Big occasion. Are you going to steal the show?
I'm going to steal the show, baby.
How do we win?
Knockout.
Huge night for women's boxing. For you to be topping the bill there is a real moment, isn't it?
It really is, honestly. I boxed here 3 years ago at, like, what is it, half six. That was me.
You know what? I'm going back to 2010, 2012 when I come up to see you as an amateur to think how you've moved forward, progressed, and now in one of the biggest boxing fights, women's boxing fights of all time.
Yeah, it's just gone.
You're still trying to get it. You're still trying to take it in, aren't you?
It's amazing. It's absolutely amazing for the fact that I can look back and say, look how far I've come.
Yeah, brilliant, Savannah. I wish you the best of luck tonight.
Cheers, thank you.
20 seconds.
Kappa!
20,000 people. There's probably 17 or 18,000 in here now. Historic night for women's boxing, and you're a part of that. How's it feel?
Do you know what? I try and keep a straight face every time I walk off. Game face, mean business. I come out and I couldn't help but smile, man. I looked up and I was like, wow. I heard people cheering, and it's just, this is what all the little girls look up and want to do. Do you know what I mean? For me, I just wanted to be a pro boxer. I was like, I don't really care who I box in front of. The less, the better for me, because I can control my nerves better. But what a night, and I am so happy to be a part of it.
Head up, lads! Pause, guys! Pause, guys! Jump on! Mad!
Lauren, how was that?
Oh, do you know what? The atmosphere, you know, just even on that ring walk, stepping out, I had goosebumps, you know, it was absolutely amazing. This is where we all want to be, you know. For myself, Karis and Caroline, you know, we're looking up to the likes of, obviously, you know, Savannah and Anna and Clarissa headlining on show. This is a dream come true. And yeah, it's just absolutely phenomenal.
What a fight.
Man, what a fight. So thankful. I want to say thank you to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for putting me here, for blessing me in this moment. I'm highly favored. My steps were ordained. I was supposed to win tonight.
Yeah, you know what? That was one of those fights where you started very well, and Michaela done what she does best, and she started grinding it out. But you came back strong again at the end. It was a real thriller.
It was. You know, I knew I had to dig deep. I knew that I still felt like I was in her backyard. I still felt that I needed to still make it decisive that I won. And I did that. I became the unified champion of the world.
Jill Scott, England International, now at a women's, all women's boxing event. What are we thinking?
Oh, what an incredible event. It's such an honor to be here. Nearly 20,000 people, obviously all women's fights, it's just incredible.
You do.
I've just got to say, got to congratulate you on an amazing fight. That was definitely fight of the year contender. How did you feel it went in there?
It was a tough fight. I tried my best. I just came up short.
That was what it was. It was like you was always in the fight, but she was just nicking the rounds. It was one of those, it was entertaining, like I say, fight of the year, really close, but she was just nicking some of those rounds and that made the difference.
Yeah, it was at the end. She kept catching me with that backhand. It always seemed to be within the last 10, 15 seconds.
Well, listen, you two proved you're the outstanding middleweights in the world there. Are we going to see that again?
Hopefully, yeah. She said she'd give me a rematch, so let's hope it happens.
Brilliant. Listen, congratulations on an amazing performance, amazing fight, and fight of the year contender.
Thank you. Cheers, Ben.
Pia, we have just witnessed an incredible fight, an historic night of boxing, all women's fight there. 20,000 people sold out. The atmosphere was incredible. We was expecting an amazing fight, and boy, did it deliver.
You know, I said to Savannah, she did deliver. She delivered on everything I asked. I said, I want you to put it all on the line. Don't come out of here with any regrets. This is a fight, it ain't a boxing match. Get stuck in, it's a fight, rip it up in there. And she done just that.
Yeah, that's exactly
that,
that's.
And that you can't ask for no more.
Yeah, that's exactly what she done. And Clarissa, to her credit, she showed why she's the quote. She went with her. She, you know, she bit on her gum shield and she went with her. And it made an incredible fight.
Oh, it made an incredible fight. And she did go with her and she needs maximum respect. But like I say, let's get it on next year. We'll get the rematch. Let's get it on again.
Brilliant. That sounds great. You know, two outstanding middleweights. We need to see it again.
Well, we need to see it again. We've got a rematch clause there. So there's not going to be any warm-ups. Next year, let's get it back on.
Brilliant. Pete, thanks so much.
You proved you are the GOAT. What a performance. What a fight.
I can't wait to go home and watch it.
Oh, wow. That has got to be fight of the year contender.
It got to be. You know, I was like, if I could slip that big-ass jab and hit her with a hook, I'd get her out of here. And I seen it, but she had her hand glued here. I said, okay, how about we slip the jab and hit her with the right hand? The right hand was working, but it just, I think I spent, the time I spent on the rope, she landed some good shots, and that's probably how she caught me in my eye, and I wasn't able to see for a few rounds, but I just started to fight on the inside and get the job done. Early rounds, when I was out boxing and landing my jab, I dug to the body a couple times because I felt she had some strength, and she'd trick you in there because she'll throw this little soft jab, and it's not really hard, but then she'll come with a big one, or she'll throw her soft jabs, and then she'll throw a hard jab, and she got power. So when I seen what kind of power she had, I said, okay, I see what she's trying to do. I made her miss a lot with her big hook she was trying to throw. I rolled a lot of them. I had to be defensively sound. Anybody that fights against her has to be defensively sound on the inside and outside.
Who next? What would be the dream?
Right now.
I mean, you're running out of opponents.
Yeah, but you know, it's always some up-and-coming girls. I mean, we got Natasha Jonas and Terry Harper at 154. I can make 154. When I was at 54, the only girl that was there was Marie Eve DeCare and Ivana Habazine. That's how I became undisputed there. But now you got some heavy hitters in Terry Harper and Natasha Jonas. And if they're going to fight against 54, they need to fight against the 154 queen, which is me.
Clarissa Shields, honestly, what an unbelievable performance. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you guys for having me. Thank you.